Good day, mateys, and thanks for tubing in to Pirates and Teepees. I've pretty much got my S500 drone put together, so I'm going to show you how I mounted everything and give you a couple little warnings so maybe you don't make the same mistakes I made, and maybe you can get some ideas of where you want to mount your equipment onto your S500. So, first thing, that's most important, if you don't watch any more of this video, watch this part. On the back here, you'll see that there are solder connections for your power input and your power supply module. See the plus here? See how this is shaped like a minus? You might think that's positive and that's negative. It is not. This is positive and this is negative. This is positive and this is negative. And you want to hook yours up accordingly so you don't end up with a dead short like I did. You can kind of see I've still got a little bit of fry on my battery connector and this connector here. I was able to continue to use it, but yeah, that could have been catastrophic. I did blow a little bit of the traces out, but not enough to break anything. Next thing was mounting the controller on top here. The mount holes that are on the mount that came with my kit didn't really line up, so I used the Dremel to sand out edges here so I can still get to these bolts for attaching and removing the top piece. I took apart the power supply that came with my kit, if you can see that in there, and then just have it so it's only got power input of the big power, and then re-put another piece of shrink wrap over it, and then just have the power output that goes to the flight controller. Inside here is where I have put the telemetry device with the antenna facing down through the hole in the bottom of the drone. See that there? And then also underneath there, I have my receiver sandwiched in there for the radio. And then right here, I've used a tie wrap in order to connect the antennas from the receiver there. So I have like a nice smooth antenna and it's not going to get caught up in the blades. I added LED strip lights to the bottom of this and then just soldered them on with the speed control here. So these light up. So I got lights underneath. The gimbal just mounts on your rails that are supplied with the supplied mounts that come with most gimbals, which is really cool. And yeah, so I'm going to plug this thing in so you can see it all light up. And hope that's inspired you to get your S500 going, maybe giving you some ideas of things you want to do similar or differently than I've done it. I've got a little connector here so I can take the gimbal on and off easy. Boom, boom. And let me power this baby up. Ooh, look at that. Pretty lights. We got lights underneath. We got a gimbal going. And yeah, all flashy and good. I'm getting GPS signal. The one thing I haven't figured out is, beepiness, is how to get the little remote USB. I've got the remote USB device hooked here that's supposed to have a light on it and then also allow you to hook your USB up to it. I don't know if I'm gonna ever need it. It's mounted, the wires are here. So all I got left to do now, I've got two more speed controls to solder on. I've got one ready to go here. I'm about to do a how-to video on this one. So I'm gonna put that together. And then the next thing to do is gonna be calibrate the speed controls, calibrate the flight controller, and then do a test flight. So I hope you've enjoyed these series of videos so far. Thanks again. Share this video, hit that like button, subscribe to my channel. It means a lot to me. I've got a giveaway of some Raspberry Pis coming up. I got some Pi Zeros from Adafruit. I'm gonna do a giveaway. So keep an eye out for that giveaway video to tell you how to enter to win those. And I want to say thanks for all the awesome comments I've been getting from everyone. It makes it really fun for me. I love helping you guys out. Love the positive reinforcement. So cool. Thanks again, and have a piratical day.